Good morning, friends. Welcome in this class. This video is for class 7, subject social science, and we are studying about geography chapter 4 here. It is the second lecture of this chapter, and in today's lecture, the topics which are to be covered or discussed are like these. First one, weather and climate. Second, temperature. Third, air pressure. And fourth, wind. Yes, friends, in our previous lecture, we have studied about atmosphere and its structure. As we know, our Earth is surrounded by a thick layer of various kinds of gases and other particles. So, this envelope of air is known as atmosphere. And atmosphere is divided into 5 different layers. These layers are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. Yes, troposphere is the lowest and densest layer of the atmosphere, and the layer extends up to a height of 16 km. Okay, and means all the weather changes or weather phenomena occurred in this layer. And the second layer is stratosphere, and this layer is or means just lie above the troposphere, and its thickness is about 50 kilometers, and this layer is free from clouds and all weather related phenomena. So, and the layer has rich layer of ozone, which protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. And the third layer is mesosphere, and it stretches from 50 km to 80 km, and it just lie about the stratosphere, and in this layer meteors are burnt. Next layer is thermosphere. It lies between 50 to 400 km, okay, and this layer helps in radio transmission. And the last layer is exosphere. Understood? Yes, in today's lecture, now we will have a discussion on weather and climate. Yes, friends, weather. Most of the students get confused in weather and climate. Okay, like season, weather and climate. Okay, now I will tell you the difference between weather and climate. Understood? Yes, like weather is the hour-to-hour, day-to-day condition of the atmosphere. Yes, friends, actually, what do you mean by the weather? Weather is the day-to-day changing condition of atmosphere. Okay, and weather can change dramatically from day to day. Means in a day or during a day, weather changes many times. Okay, means weather changes many times in a day. As we experience or see that means weather of the day may be shiny or may be cloudy, rainy, windy. Okay, so means weather changes many times in a day, and the factors which affect the weather, these are heat, rainfall, wind. Okay, and now about the climate. Yes, friends, climate is the average weather condition of a place for a longer period of time, and it remains same throughout the years. Humidity, temperature are some factors affect the climate. Yes, friends, actually, what is the difference between climate and weather? Listen carefully. Ki weather is the day-to-day changing condition. Okay, means weather changes many times in a day. But what do you mean by climate? Climate is the average weather condition of a place for a longer period of time. Means weather changes occur in a small area or for a short period of time. But climate, that it covers large areas and remains same throughout the year. Understood? Okay. Means these are some differences between weather and climate. And the factors which affect the weather, like the wind, sunshine, temperature, rainfall, and the climate affecting factors are humidity and temperature. So, understood the difference between weather and climate? Weather is the day-to-day changing condition, and the climate is average weather condition. That weather's, okay, changes many times in a day, climate remains same throughout the year. And weather changes occur for a short period of time and for in a short areas also. It covers short area, but climates that covers large area and changes over a long period of time. Understood? Yes. Now our next topic is temperature. Yes friends, what do you know about the temperature? Actually, temperature is the degree of hotness and coldness of the air. And the temperature of the atmosphere changes not only day and night, but also from season to season. Yes, this we know that, and we experience it in our daily life also. Like there is a difference in the degree of hotness or coldness or the temperature. Okay, during the daytime and at the night time. Yes, during the daytime, the temperatures becomes much hot, means temperature rises. Okay, and at the night times, the temperature decreases. Yes or no, means nights are cooler than day. Okay, and we experience different that amount of temperature in the season wise also. Like we experience the more hotter temperature at the summer season, and during the winter season the temperature decreases. Okay, yes. Now next one is there, that is insulation. Yes friends, what do you know about the insulation? Actually, insulation is the incoming or the amount of solar energy which are interrupted by the earth. Understood? Okay, means the amount of heat received by the earth from the sun. Okay, and the important factor of that influence the distribution of temperature is insulation. Okay, means the amount of heat received by the earth, okay, is not equal everywhere. Yes or no? Okay, means some areas are there which experience very hot weather, and some areas are there in the world which experience very cold weather. Okay, and it depends on the amount of heat received by the earth. Okay, yes friends, actually the amount of the heat, sun heat received by the earth is not equal on all places. Okay, yes, means the places which lies near the equator, they are much hotter or great hotter than the places which are lying near the poles. So what is the reason behind it? Actually, the places which lies near the equator, so on these places sun rays fall directly. Okay, means they receive much amount of heat. That's why the temperature in these areas is always remains high. Okay, and the places which are near to the equator, okay, so near to the equator the sun rays do not fall directly. Okay, means these areas receive very less amount of heat in comparison to the equatorial places. Understood? Okay, so the amount of heat received by the earth is not equal on all places. Now some other factors about the temperature, means the standard unit of measuring temperature is degree Celsius, means temperature is measured in degree Celsius. Okay, and it was invented by Anders Celsius. On the Celsius scale, the water freezes at 0 degree Celsius and boils at 100 degree Celsius. This we know that at 0 degree Celsius, the water gets freezed. Okay, and at 100 degree Celsius, the water starts or gets boiling. Temperature in cities is much higher than that of villages. Yes, this also we experience that in cities always means the temperature is higher in comparison to the rural areas. The reason is there, like in cities big buildings are there, roads are there which are made up of concrete and which can get heat very quickly, means receive or absorb much amount of heat. Okay, and this heat is released during the night time. Okay, so that's why that the cities have high temperature in comparison to the rural areas or villages. Okay. Yes. Next, our topic is there, that is air pressure. Yes, friends. What is air pressure? Okay. Air pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by the weight of air on the earth surface. Okay. And the air pressure is highest at sea level and decreases with height. And in the areas where temperature is high and the air gets heated and rises. Actually, students, atmospheric pressure at a place is affected by two major factors. First is temperature and second is altitude, means height. Okay, now I will tell you about it. Like temperature. When air is heated, it expands, okay, and becomes light and rises vertically. So, rising warm air exerts very little pressure on the surface and this causes a low pressure area. Similarly, when air is cooled, it becomes heavy and sinks vertically and exerts greater pressure on the surface and creates high pressure area. Understood? Yes, the second factor is height, altitude. The upper atmosphere is very thin and less dense than the lower atmosphere. So, the pressure is also less and keeps decreasing with increasing altitude or height. That's why the air pressure is highest as at sea level and decreases with height. Okay, means the air pressure is highest at sea level and as much as we go higher, this pressure decreases. Understood about it? So, which are the two factors affect the air pressure? First one is temperature and second is altitude. So, temperature I explained means the area where temperature is high, the air gets heated and rises. This I told you, means when the air is heated, it expands and becomes light and rises vertically. And rising warm air exerts very little pressure on the surface and causing low pressure areas. Understood? Yes. Low pressure is associated with cloudy skies and wet weather. Yes, friends, means the low pressure areas always experience bad weather. Okay, means they experience like cloudy skies and then storm, heavy rainfall. This type of weather is experienced in low pressure areas. And in areas having lower temperature, the air is cold and heavy. This I told you. Yes, means heavy air sinks and create a high pressure area. High pressure is associated with clear and sunny skies. Okay, and the air always move from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. So, which areas experience that bad weather? Low pressure areas. Okay, and the high pressure areas, in these areas, weather is always clear and sunny. Okay. And the air always moves from high pressure areas to low pressure areas. Understood? Yes. Now, and this is the reasons of the movement of wind also. So, what do you mean by the wind? Means the movement of air from high pressure areas to low pressure areas is known as wind. Okay, now we will study about the types of wind. Yes, students, actually wind is of mainly three types. These are permanent winds, seasonal winds and local winds. Okay, now we will read about these three types of winds. Yes, first is there, that is permanent winds. Okay, yes, the trade wind, west lies and east lies are the permanent winds. And these blow constantly throughout the year in a particular direction. Yes, friends, what do you mean by the permanent wind? Okay, means the winds which blow in a particular directions throughout the year, which are known as permanent winds. Means the winds which do not change their directions. Okay, means winds which blow in a particular direction, okay, continuously or constantly without changing throughout the year are known as permanent winds. Okay, and these permanent winds are also known as planetary winds. Okay, and it is because of the permanent pressure belt on the earth surface. Understood? And in the diagram also you can see that the winds which blow from the equatorial regions to the northern sorry southern pole, okay, and northern poles. Okay, means the airs or the winds which blow from the equator or sorry that north pole to equator, okay, and south pole to equator. Okay, ki these types of these winds always blow in a particular direction, they never change their direction. Understood? Yes. Now next one is there, that is seasonal wind. Seasonal wind means the winds which blow in a particular season only. Okay, means these winds do not flow throughout the year. These winds blow in a particular time, in a particular season. Okay, for example, monsoon winds in India. Yes, I think everybody knows about it. The monsoon winds means the winds which bring rainfall. Okay, and these winds blow from southern part to northern part. Okay, means from the south to north in India at the month or at the season of means rainy season, during the rainy seasons. So these are, means these winds blow in a particular season only in the rainy seasons. So this type of winds are known as seasonal winds. Okay, and next one is their local winds. Yes, friends, these blow only during a particular period of the day or year in a small areas. Okay, means these winds do not blow you can say all over the areas. These winds which blow in only a particular area, they cover small areas and they blow in a particular time period also. Like as we know that in summer season, okay, in summer season that hot winds blow in only northern part of India, especially in Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan. Okay, means these winds do not flow in the other parts of India. Okay, they cover a small part or area of only some states like Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan. Okay, so these hot winds are known as loo also. Okay, and land breeze and sea breeze. Okay, these are also known as local wind. Okay, now we will have a discussion on land and sea breeze. Yes, friends, sea breeze. During daytime, the sun often quickly heats up land. Okay, so first you must know about the sea breeze. Ki what are the breeze? Means the winds, or you can say the air which blow from sea to land. From sea to land are known as sea breeze. Okay, and how these winds blow, how these things is created, now I'll explain it. Actually, as we know that during the daytime, okay, the sun often quickly heats up land. Okay, and the air above the land gets warmer than the air above the water. Yes, friends, as we know that the land areas gets heat more quickly in comparison to water. Okay, so means as the air above the land is warmer, it gets less dense and it begins to rise. Okay, and in this way it created low pressure areas. So the denser air above the water moves to the space above the land, and this cooler air is now, this is known as sea breeze. Understood? Yes, in simple words, if I tell you that during the daytime, the land near the sea, the land near the sea, that it quickly heats up. Okay, and so the air above this land area gets warmer. Okay, then the air which is above the water in the sea. Okay, so as we know that the hot air always rises up. Okay, so when this hot air of the land rises up, okay, so it creates a space or volume. Okay, so means and now the air which is dense, cold and heavy over the water, so this air that blew to cover or this volume or this space. Okay, so in this way that the wind blow from sea to land, and this is known as sea breeze. Understood? And it happens during daytime. Sea breeze always move or blow during daytime. Now, what happened at the night time? We will see now. That is land breeze. Yes, friends, at the night time, the loss of heat source causes land to quickly cool down, which causes the heat to be released towards the surrounding air. Just I told you that the land gets quickly, you can say, heat and cool down, okay, in comparison to water. Means water that gets heat and cool down very slowly in comparison to land. Okay, so during the night time, okay, the land is you can say hotter in comparison to the water. Okay, so at that time, means as compared to land, the water retains heat longer, and which causes the air above it to have lesser density and rise. Okay, so means during the night time, the land gets cooled down quickly in comparison to the water. So this time, the air which is over the water is, you can say, much hotter in comparison to the air over the land. Okay, so this time, low pressure area is created above the water, because this time the air on the water is hot and it rises up, and now the space or volume is created over the water. Okay, and so this time the heavy and dense air of the land, okay, that it moves to take or cover this space. So this time that the air or wind blow from land to sea, and these are known as land breeze. Understood? Yes. And these winds blow during night time. Now you can see in the diagram also, here I have seen land and sea breeze. Now listen, first give a look on the first part, daytime. Okay, daytime, if you see that warm land surface, means land surface is much warmer in comparison to the water. So at the land surface, the warm air rises. Okay, so in that conditions, the air over the water, okay, which is dense, it blows, okay, it blows to create or to take this space. So that time the wind blows from sea to water. Understood? Yes. Next one is there. Next one is there, that is night time. Okay. So that night time, that cool breeze moving towards the sea. Understood? And at that time, where is that warm or hot air is there? Above the sea surface. And this air rises up, and this time the cool breeze towards the, means from the land, they blow from that land to sea. From sea to land. Okay, this is known as sea breeze. Understood? Yes. Next one is, okay, there. Now next topic is homework. So beta, in this way our today's lecture is completed. Now I'll assign you some question answer, and the answer of this question answer you have to write in your FAIR notebook, in which first question is there, that is, what is weather? Second, what is air pressure? Next question, what are the different types of winds? Just I told you the three types of wind: permanent wind, seasonal wind and local wind, and differentiate between weather and climate. Okay, now we will have a look on the homework solution. Yes, friends, in yesterday lecture, some question answers were given to you to solve, in which first is there, in which layer of the atmosphere do aeroplanes fly? Yes, stratosphere. As I told that this layer is free from weather phenomena. Okay, so that is safe for flying aeroplanes. So where do meteors burn up in the atmosphere? Mesosphere. What is atmosphere? The earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air, which is known as atmosphere. Which gas protects us from harmful sun rays? Yes, ozone layer. And this is found in Which layer? Stratosphere. Which layer of the atmosphere is free from clouds? Stratosphere. Stratosphere layer is almost free from clouds or all weather changing phenomena. Understood? So in this way, our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with our next lecture and with next topics. Thank you.